Puff the Magic Dragon, written by Peter Yarrow. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. Little Jackie Paper loved the rascal Puff and brought him strings and sealing wax and other fancy stuff. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. Together they would travel on a boat with billowed sail. Jackie kept a lookout perched on Puff's gigantic tail. Noble kings and princes would bow whenever they came. Pirate ships would lower their flag when Puff roared out his name. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. A dragon lives forever, but not so little girls and boys. Painted wings and giant's rings make way for other toys. One gray night, it happened. Jackie Paper came no more. And Puff, that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow. Green scales felt like rain. Puff no longer went to play along the cherry lane. Without his lifelong friend, Puff could not be brave. So Puff, the mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii. Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolii.
Magic dragon lived by the sea wings and giant's rings make way for other toys. One gray night it happened, Jackie Paper came no more, and Puff, that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow, green scales fell like rain. Puff no longer went to play along the cherry lane. Without his lifelong friend, Puff could not be brave. So Puff, that mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave.